Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to my channel. I hope you guys have all been doing well. I recently filmed an Amazon favorites video for you guys, which if you haven't seen it, I'll put the thumbnail somewhere here for you guys and I'll link it down below. But in that video, I had my nails done with the nails that I was talking about in my Amazon favorites video, because I do get these off of Amazon and kind of like just paint them and do them myself. And in that video, there were so many of you guys that commented saying, I'd love to see a tutorial, or my God, I love your nail. So I really appreciate that because I love hearing from you guys and I usually respond to like every single comment. So thank you again for even leaving a comment, but I wanted to go ahead and give you guys what you want. So today I am filming how I do these nails here with the nails that I get from Amazon. I figured honestly this would be a perfect time since, you know, with everything going on, the pandemic, the COVID-19 coronavirus, that a lot of people can't get to the nail salons. I get so many compliments on them. So I'm glad that you guys noticed them in that video. Now I'll probably insert like some better footage here and like pictures of what the nails actually look like. Is that all I needed to tell you guys? Yeah. And if you guys are new here, you should definitely subscribe down below. I would love to have you part of our family here on YouTube. I do a number of different videos, makeup, fashion, lifestyle, nails now. So we're gonna add that. Of course, I do have an older nail video from like 2-3 years ago, but it ain't the best, okay? I ain't gonna lie. So if you guys wanna see how I got my nails did by me, then let's just go ahead and let's get started. Hey guys, so let's go ahead and get started. These are what my nails look like without any, obviously, nails on. I did trim them down for the sake of this video, but these are the nails that I use. I got them off of Amazon and I just looked, they did go up a few bucks. They're $13.99 now. They were $8.99 when I bought them a few weeks ago. I got them in the natural finish, but they do come in clear as well. You're going to need a nail file. You're going to need a top coat. This Sally Hansen one I've used for years, which you can also get on Amazon. The cuticle pusher backer thing. I don't even know what the correct terminology is there. The glue, and I always use the Kiss Maximum Speed Glue. You can find pretty much anywhere. And then these are the polishes. I'm gonna use the black one, but that colorful one is the one that I had on in my Amazon video that a lot of you guys really liked. So first thing that you're gonna want to do is pretty much just size up the nail with your nail bed. I have very small narrow nail beds and these fit perfectly. Like the pinky is obviously the smallest of them and it fits mine perfectly. Just make sure on the sides that you don't have a lot of your nail showing. I did find that on some of these, I can't go up too big on the sides because then the sides of my nails, they'll pop off. So you want to, if anything, go a little bit smaller than the nail kind of overextending, if that even makes sense. So I just lay them out. It's just going to make it a lot easier as you begin to apply them. And then I'm going to take this cuticle nail pusher backer. I don't know. I'm gonna have to look up the terminology, but it's just one that I had laying around and I'm just pushing back the cuticles. I am not a professional, okay? So all you nail techs out there, don't come for me. This is just what I do. And it you know, I get at least 2 weeks, if not 2.5 weeks out of this when I do this process. So I just push them back. And then when we put the nail on, you'll kind of see me kind of pushing it under the cuticle, which I'll show you in a little bit. But you just want to push those back. And then I feel like this is the most important step that a lot of people skip out on. And I think that's why a lot of people's nails don't last the full like 2-2.5 weeks. I just take the nail file and kind of just rough up the surface of my nail. Just to kind of get some grooves in my nail bed, because then the glue will kind of like sink in there and I just feel like it adheres a lot better as opposed to applying glue on a smooth surface. So just rough them up, you know, don't file them down to you know, the bone, just enough to just kind of for that glue to grip on. And then I always just take the nail file, and because these are coffin shaped, you don't want the sides of your nails to show too much. So I always just file those down just very slightly. And then this is the glue that I use. I know this is pretty popular. A lot of people use this and I've been using this for years as well. I order mine off Amazon. You can get it at Walmart, the drugstore. So it's pretty easy to find. This is just the best glue that I found, you know, works for me. Then pretty much just common sense, just go ahead. I put the nail glue on. What kind of, I'm trying to think of like the best way for me to describe this. I kind of like
put a dot of it on and just use the tip of the applicator, just kind of like spread it all out. You want to use less glue, okay? So don't go in there and put too much glue on, because sometimes too much glue can actually do the opposite and your nail is going to pop right off after a few days if you even make it that far. So I kind of just put a little bit of dot on, kind of smear it out, and then I go in with the nail. And I'll show you here if you guys can even see, but I kind of take the nail, kind of push it under my cuticle, and I feel like this is another step to ensure that you get like the best lasting power out of these nails. You just want them to be on there as best as you can. So roughing up the nail bed a little bit with the nail file, and then kind of pushing that bottom or top, I guess you could probably the top of the nail, I guess, but just kind of push it under that cuticle, like nothing too crazy. Don't make yourself bleed about this, but just get it under there, because it's going to keep it from getting like knocked off when you're doing, you know, just like your household chores and things like that. And then I'm just going to go ahead and just apply all of them. I don't know how much footage I showed you guys, but maybe I showed you this full hand. I'm not gonna do both hands for you guys because I'm pretty sure you guys kind of get the concept, but I did just get so many requests to show you guys how I got those nails in that Amazon video, and that's why I'm just showing you in one hand. And then I'm gonna go ahead and do my probably other hand off of camera. Just wanted to give you guys a little bit more of a close-up here of what I mean when I say push that, kind of like, you know, tug up that cuticle and get it under there. And like, look at this, look at the shape though. Like, seriously, these are like the most perfect length and shape for me. And I don't even trim them down at all. The only thing that we're gonna do is see how like on the end of the nail, and most false nails have that little tab at the end. I just take the nail file, like you can see right there on the ring finger. I just take the nail file and just do like a couple, you know, couple strokes just to smooth that out, but I don't do any shaping. This is the shape that they come in, which is why I love these, because it's less work in the long run. So if you like this shape, I'll definitely have them all linked down below. I'll actually have everything, you know, linked down below for you guys. I'll have the links to these nails, to these polishes. Like I said, I will link the colorful one down there for you guys, but I'm gonna use the black and white one because I was really excited to use it. I got these both at Sally's. This brand right here that I'm using is from the brand Finger Paints. It's like just under $5 at Sally's. And I wanted to show you guys what one coat would look like, which is nice. This is, I actually would probably do just one coat, but for the sake of this video, I wanted it just to be a little bit more, you know, that you guys can even see, and just do two layers just to see what that looked like. And I actually prefer the two layers that you'll see, but one layer is not bad. I mean, sometimes with these types of polishes, like glitters and that, you have to go with, like, I swear, 4 to 5 layers, but look at the first layer. Like, you pretty much get a nice payoff. So if you want the first layer, this is what it looks like. But I do in a minute here go in with a second coat. But I love this polish, and this is the first time I've used this brand of finger paints. I just liked what it looked like in the bottle, and it ended up turning out like really, really great. So that's one coat. So I am gonna go in right here with the second coat and take you guys through that, and you'll see kind of what the difference is. But for me personally, definitely two coats. Usually any nail polish that I do, I always do two coats regardless. So I'm gonna finish up my nails here, and what's next? Put on the top coat, which I'll show you guys in just a second. They're so pretty, and I am so excited to experiment with like jewels and things. So if I get a little bit, you know, creative with these nails, I'll definitely continue to film them for you guys. If it's something that you're interested in, just let me know down below. But this is what they look like with two coats, and they are now dry. So I am gonna go in with my top coat, with that Sally Hansen top coat. This Sally Hansen top coat that I use, I think I've used this, I swear to God, it's been at least 5 years. This is the best top coat because it's thick, it dries, it's thick, but it spreads out like easily. You know what I mean? Like, you know how sometimes you get those top coats that they're like a thick, super thick gel and it's kind of hard to brush on? That's not like this at all. It's easy to apply, but I just feel like my, you know, polish stays on so much longer with this top coat. And I think I've even mentioned it in an empties video, so I'll definitely have it linked down below for you guys. But these are the final results. I hope you guys really enjoyed. It's so simple, you should definitely try it out. And yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye.